2023 was the year of updates and upgrades from Uniden. Let's break it all down. In July of 2023, Joe Bearcat, the new spokesperson for Uniden, made an announcement on Radio Reference that they were going to release two brand new scanner radios to the market. Now, of course, we don't know when they're coming out yet, but I'm hopeful they're going to come out this year. The first radio is a BCD-160DN. The second one is a BCD-260DN. Basically, they're both the same radio, except one is a handheld and one is a base mobile radio. Both of these radios look identical to scanners that we might already own, but there's a difference hiding underneath the cases of each one of these. Both of these radios are analog, NXDN, DMR, but no P25 and no trunking. That's right. No P25, no trunking, conventional only, analog, DMR, and NXDN. There are no other scanner radios on the market that are set up this way. And what's really interesting about these radios is they use what I would call a linear style of programming. In other words, that means you have a set number of banks, and inside of each bank, you have a set number of memory slots. For example, 10 banks of 100 gives you 1,000 memory channels, which again, I think one of these radios actually has. This means you don't need to master Uniden's DMA style programming, which means you have to set up a system, a group, and then enter in your frequencies or talk groups. This will make setting up one of these radios a whole lot easier. And these new radios are going to hit a very, very interesting market. See, prior to this, from Uniden, you would need a radio that was P25 and trunked capable. You're looking at spending somewhere around $350 in order to just get the radio in your possession. Then on top of that, you'd have to pay additionally for a licensing key to put DMR and or NXDN on your system. So for example, if you wanted both NXDN and DMR, you'd have to pay for two additional licenses, making that radio almost $150 more than the $350 you just spent to buy that radio. And if all that you need is a DMR or NXDN conventional frequency, that's a lot of money just to listen to something. Now, why would we want to listen to just a DMR or NXDN conventional frequency? There are plenty of police departments or fire districts or water districts, municipalities, other entities that went the way of putting a DMR frequency in place or even NXDN, because it allows you to have talk groups, which gives you more use of your available licensed spectrum. For example, if you were only licensed to have one frequency, you could use talk groups on that same frequency to set up a group for dispatch, talk around, chiefs, ambulance. You really could benefit from an NXDN or a DMR system, because on DMR, you could have two different talk groups operating at the exact same time, because DMR uses what we call time division multiple access, or TDMA, which means really quickly, you have user one and then user two, user one, user two, user one, user two. So when you have that done, you've got two users talking at the exact same time. You've doubled your capacity on a single frequency. So the BCD-160DN looks identical to a BC-125AT. The BCD-260DN looks almost identical to the BCD-996P2. And while at this point, at the time of recording, there's no release date from Uniden, and there's also no price point. And I'm really hopeful in the next few weeks, we will have both of those. And I gotta tell you something, I'll be one of the first people to hand my credit card over to get a pre-order on both of these radios. And of course, as soon as they get here, I'll be sure to post a video on my initial reactions, the unboxings, and everything else that comes with owning a new piece of gear from Uniden. I am beyond excited to get two new radios into the market and into my hands. Do I need a BCD-160DN or a 260DN? No, I am not the target audience. The target audience is somebody that has the need to monitor a single DMR channel or an NXDN channel that doesn't want to pay for P25. And again, there's also plenty of rail systems in the US that are using analog and NXDN. So this would be the perfect radio for somebody like that as well. I already have NXDN radios and DMR radios that are built into my P25 radios. But again, you bet your bottom dollar, I'm buying one of each. And before we move on to the next bit of news from Uniden, I want to take a moment to thank my Patreon supporters. Without their help and support, I couldn't bring these podcast episodes over into a video platform like YouTube. And my Patreon supporters get benefits by supporting the podcast, such as getting the podcast early and also without this upcoming break. If you want to help support the podcast and see all the benefits that you can receive by being a supporter, go to scannerschool.com/Patreon. Just days before 2023 came to a close, Uniden released a couple of updates and feature enhancements to the SDS 100 and the SDS 200. These came out of left field, but let me tell you, one of these paid feature enhancements completely shocked me, and I think it shocked the entire hobby. So before we get into what you have to pay for, let's talk about what Uniden gave us for free. We get a new version of Sentinel. Now, it looks just like the old version, performs just like the old version. It just allows us to use the new feature. Uniden claims that the firmware update improves digital reception, although some have noticed a degradation in Pro Voice. They fixed a problem with P25 Phase 2 and the unit IDs not displaying on the screen. There's improved P25 Phase 2 detection. There's improved P25 DMR NXDN OFT signal detection rate. There's an updated filter for P25 Phase 1 DMR NXDN. And they say they've increased the speed of scanning. They've also improved the accuracy of the readings for the RSSI and the number of signal bars. And of course, the biggest update that we got with this firmware is a waterfall display. Now, this waterfall display is something, again, I don't think anybody saw coming. But before we talk about that one, they also released a patch or an update because, of course, when you add new features, you add new bugs. So the final firmware release for 2023 fixed backlight restoration when re-entering scan modes, fixed an issue where the signal bar RSSI would not be displayed when a weak signal was received. But they also added a key lock feature by pressing the function key and the power button in order to activate it. And this takes the SDS 100 to where we kind of needed it because other handheld scanners by Uniden allowed you to lock the keypad. And I know this was something that I really wish that you didn't had initially added to the SDS 100, but I'm just glad to see it now. So let's talk about this waterfall and why it's such a cool feature. Now, if you already don't know, the SDS 100 and the SDS 200 was rebuilt from the ground up. Basically, instead of it being built on conventional hardware that other scanners were built upon, these are software-defined radios under the hood. The SDS, right, the software-defined scanner. And if you've ever seen an SDR in action, what you really look at on your screen, your computer screen, your tablet, whatever it is that you're viewing your SDR on, you get what's called on the top an FFT, and then below that, you get a waterfall display. Now, the FFT is basically a window, and it shows you your usable or receivable frequency in a range. So from the bottom to the top of this window would be what the SDR or the scanner is looking at. And in the FFT display, we'll get little spikes. And these are active carriers. And we can move our mouses over and click on things, right, in the typical SDR fashion. This is nice because you can see real time in an RF environment where there's active users. So if you're actually out there hunting, looking for, a frequency to listen to, this can really help you. And again, we always say here in the podcast that the secrets are in the searches, and this is just another tool in our toolbox. Now, below the FFT, we have a waterfall. And what's the difference between an FFT and the waterfall? Well, the waterfall shows what's happening over time. So depending on how fast the waterfall falls, we have a little marker, right, across the waterfall when we receive something in the FFT. So if it's like a blurp or a quick little transmission, you get a little dot on the waterfall. And of course, as the waterfall moves over time, you can see that dot falling. If it's a longer transmission, say something like a dispatch, you'll see a longer line falling down the waterfall. Of course, when that frequency or that user dekeys, that's when that line stops in the waterfall and eventually it falls off the screen. But if you have something like an FM broadcast channel, you'll have a steady line that just goes down the waterfall. So a waterfall is really great to have if you're looking for active frequencies, and of course, you're not going to see them in an FFT display. For example, if you monitor aviation, you know there's a lot of frequencies. You can listen to different things happening on aviation. And if you have a waterfall display, you'll see the little bips, and you'll see the longer tails, and you'll see where every single aviation, you know, transmission is taking place. But this becomes even more important if we're trying to monitor something like mil-air, because those transmissions are really quick, and they're almost like finding a needle in a haystack sometimes. So a waterfall display can really help us identify and locate active frequencies over time. On an upcoming podcast episode, we will break down how to get the waterfall upgrade and how to pay for it and download it and register your scanner on Uniden's website. We'll talk about how to apply the firmware upgrade, and we'll show you how to use the waterfall. So be sure you subscribe to us on YouTube and also on your favorite podcast player so you can take this podcast episode with you in the car or out on a jog or maybe even on the gym if that's your New Year's resolution, because you don't want to miss this upcoming tutorial. But in the meantime, why don't you join the ongoing conversation with our ScanNerds community? We've got two great groups going depending on where you like to hang out. We have a very active Discord group, and also we're on Facebook. You can join those by going to scannerschool.com/discord or scannerschool.com/facebook group. We'll catch you all on next week's podcast, 73.